Methamphetamine is a stimulant, a highly addictive drug of the amphetamine class of psychoactive drugs. It activates certain reward systems in the brain and, according to the White House, quote, has a high potential for abuse. The drug is also known as meth, ice, crystal, glass, and is called other names because of its white, powdery appearance. The substance is bitter, odorless, and easily dissolves in water. It has both medicinal and recreational uses. In low doses, methamphetamine can increase alertness, concentration, and energy in fatigued individuals. In higher doses, it can induce mania with accompanying euphoria, and can cause psychosis, delusions, hallucinations, paranoia, uncontrollable movement, impaired judgment and memory, and depression. Meth can make people hear voices, see things that aren't really there, or even believe they feel things like bugs crawling under their skin, known as crank bugs or formication. Users also suffer from persecutory delusions, believing people are out to get them or that they're under surveillance. Immediately after smoking or intravenous injection, the meth user experiences an intense sensation called a rush or flash. While that rush is described as pleasurable, it only lasts a few minutes. The rush is followed by a high that can last 6 to 8 hours. Oral or nasal use produces the same long-lasting high, but not the intense rush. On the surface, methamphetamine may seem attractive. Thus, many people are tricked or lured into using meth for the initial good feelings it brings. Some people start using meth to reduce fatigue and maintain productivity, particularly for tedious, repetitive, or physically demanding tasks or when working long hours. Some people hope it will increase their sexual desire and activity. Others just want to lose weight. Typical psychological effects of methamphetamine include euphoria, alertness or wakefulness, feelings of increased strength and renewed energy, feelings of invulnerability, feelings of increased confidence and competence, and intensified feelings of sexual desire. But whatever the excuse to use meth or whatever the perceived short-term attraction to the drug may be, the meth high is predictably followed by a devastating low.
The effectiveness of treatment generally increases when the program draws on a variety of components. Because of the inability of many meth users to recognize problems related to their drug use, techniques that promote change in patients' thinking, expectations, and behavior are emphasized. The length of the treatment program is also important. Many users have a tendency to quickly drop out of treatment, but those who continue in treatment can achieve long-term drug-free recovery. Strategies to prevent relapse may include drug education, family and group therapies, and self-help groups. These strategies often include teaching abusers to identify behaviors that put them in a situation where they are at high risk for using meth. This form of treatment provides a structure for actively involving patients in treatment and helping them stay off meth.
To make a right decision, first watch your peer group. Make sure that you surround yourself with people who don't do drugs, so you can avoid the peer pressure that you might get from your friends. Also, have a backup explanation and know the reason why you aren't going to take the drug. Lastly, knowing the effects that meth will bring to your life will help you to make a right decision.